Criminal gangs are using Airtasker-type apps to recruit children in Melbourne's escalating tobacco wars. They're being hired for single jobs like arson and car theft for as little as a few hundred dollars.
Waking up to another tobacco store firebombing, it's become a weekly routine across Melbourne.
I'm really surprised there's been no deaths. It is really but for the grace of God type moments that people haven't been killed.
Detective Inspector Graham Banks heads up Victoria Police's Lunar Task Force on the front lines against warring criminal gangs fighting for control of the illegal tobacco trade and the staggering profits that come with it.
How profitable are we talking?
Oh, it's in the hundreds of millions. Across Australia, the loss in excise is billions.
Outlaw bikie groups and gangs often run and controlled by crime figures located in the Middle East. Since March last year, 68 tobacco shops have been firebombed, plus 15 other venues also targeted as a result. Police have made over 60 arrests since October.
It goes down to as children as young as 14. So these arsons have been tasked out via encrypted applications that most people commonly have on their own phones on a Airtasker type model to do certain jobs. So you've got very young children who are breaking into houses in the first instance to steal cars while people are in those houses, often driving recklessly to different locations, and it can be for as little as $200.
$200?
That's correct.
Doesn't seem like it's worth it, does it?
Well, it's clearly not worth it. I mean, the risks that are going on, or the seriousness of the offending, you know, often is a 15-year jailable offence.
Police have warned all tobacco store owners they run the risk of being unable to claim insurance if they're firebombed and found to stock illegal tobacco.
Can it be stopped?
It can be to a large extent. There always will be a black market.
Andrew McCormack, 7 News.